In the previous session, we started solving certain numerical examples related to the concept of Colpitts and Hartley oscillators. In this session, let us continue solving some other numerical examples. Let me take the problem number 3 in your exercise. Problem number 3, exercise alli iruvanta problem number 3 na naviga start madona. Let us see what is the problem. A Colpitts oscillator oscillates at 1.13 megahertz. If the inductor in the feedback network has a value of 20 millihenry and one of the capacitors value is 0.1 microfarad, calculate the value of other capacitor. Let me read the problem once again. A Colpitts oscillator oscillates at 0.13 megahertz. So, 13 megahertz. Ili, they have given a Colpitts oscillator whose output frequency is 1.13 megahertz. That means they have, in the data part, they have given the frequency, output frequency, that is f is equal to 1.13 megahertz. Megahertz. That is frequency generated by the Colpitts oscillator. If the inductor in the feedback network, has a value of 20 microhenry and one of the capacitors value is 0.1 microfarad, calculate the value of other capacitor. That means in the tank circuit, you know that tank circuit of Colpitts oscillator consists of two capacitors and one inductor. In this problem, they have given the output frequency of the oscillator and also they have given the value of inductor and value of one capacitor, and they asked us to calculate the value of another capacitor. Among two capacitors, they have given the value of one capacitor and they asked us to calculate the value of another capacitor. Let me write the values whatever they have given. Next one they have given is inductor's value. The value of inductor is 20 microhenry. L is equal to 20 microhenry. And they have given the value of one capacitor, let it be C1. C1 andre avaru modala capacitor second capacitor anta yenu helilla, hagagi nan aa capacitor value ru C1 anta kotkondidini aitala. So nan assign madkondrantu neevu bekara C2 anta kotkondu C1 nu find out madabodu. Illi here I have assigned the given value to C1 and I am finding out the value of C2. So, value of C1 is 0.1 microfarad. And C2 is the value we need to find out. So we need to find out the value of C2. How to find out the value of C2? In the Colpitts oscillator, to find out the capacitance value, we'll make use of formula C is equal to C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. We use this formula to find out the value of capacitance. Here, we know the value of C1 and we need to find out the value of C2. To find out the value of C2, we must find out the value of C. So, how to find out the value of equivalent capacitance C? So, here, look at here, they have given the value of frequency. By using the formula of frequency, F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. By using this equation, let us find the value of equivalent capacitance C. After getting the value of equivalent capacitance C, let us find out the value of C2. To find out the equivalent capacitance C, let us equate this expression to C. So what happens if we equate this expression to C? Yen agutte northa hogana. Yeah, idana equate madodadre. So yen agutte idu equation ee tara agutte, you know, f into 2 pi athava 2 pi f. ಅಂದರೆ ಈ 2 ಪೈ ನ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಫಸ್ಟಿಗೆ. 2 ಪೈ ಎಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ರೂಟ್ ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ರೂಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ದ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ on both sides. On squaring both sides, we will get 4 pi square f square is equal to 1 divided by LC. Now, I will equate this expression to C. C means equivalent capacitance value. C is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi square f square into L. So, either equation bantu. So, let me substitute the known values in this expression and then we'll get the equivalent capacitance value. So, 1 divided by 4 into pi means 3.14 square into f square. Value of f is 1.13 megahertz. 1.13 megahertz means 1.13 into 10 to the power of 6 whole square into 10 to the power of 6 yak hakidini, because frequency is in the range of megahertz. Therefore, only 10 to the power of 6 na multiply madidini. Now, the inductor value is 20 into 10 to the power of minus 6, because it is in the range of micro. 20 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So, ee tara bandide. So, after simplifying this, we will get the capacitance value, equivalent capacitance value, that is C is equal to ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ತಪ್ಪಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡೋದು ಬೇಡ. ಸೊ ಬೇರೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ 991.9 ಪಿಕೋ ಫೆರಡ್. ಪಿಕೋ ಫೆರಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 12, ಮೈನಸ್ 12 ರೇಂಜಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಪಿಕೋ ಫೆರಡಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ನಾವು ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಸಿ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎರೇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಸಿ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್. ಇದು ನಮಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರೋವಂಥದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಸಿ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. So, C2 value, how to find out the C2 value? To find out the C2 value, we will make use of this expression. C is equal to C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Let me equate this expression to C2. How to equate this to C2? Idina e nodi, denominator of the RHS, right hand side, is brought to left hand side. Left hand side ikke tandaga enagutadu, c of c1 plus c2 is equal to c1 into c2 anta agutte. I'll remove the bracket, illiranta bracket, square bracket na remove martini. So alige enagutte, c into c1 plus c into c2 is equal to c1 into c2 anta agutte. ಸೊ ಈಗ ಈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ನನಗೆ ಸಿ ಟು ಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿ ಟು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಈ ಪಾರ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿ ಟು ಇರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಇದು, ಇದನ್ನು ಆ ಕಡೆ ತೊಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡಿಂದ ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡಿಗೆ ತೊಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸಿ ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಸಿ ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಟು ಅಂತ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಈಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸಿ ಟು ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸಿ ಟುನ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸಿ ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಟು ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಂತ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನು ಈಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಸಿ ಟುಗೆ, ಸಿ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಂತ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಟು. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಂತು, 991.9 ಅಂತ ಬಂತು. 991.9 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 12, ಅದೆಷ್ಟು ಪಿಕೋ ಫೆರಡ್ ರೇಂಜಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 12 ಇಂಟು ಸಿ ಒನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, 0.1 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಹೋಲ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 0.1 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಮೈನಸ್ 991.9 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 12 ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ expression after substitution of values. After simplifying this expression, we'll get the answer. Adna simplify madad mele namige eshtu answer barutte anta andre, we'll get the answer 0.001 microfarad. So ee answer barutte. So this is the value of C2 used in the tank circuit. So ee tara namage answer baruvantahadu. Now let us move on to next problem, that is problem number 4. Before going to the problem, let me clear the board. This problem number 4, in this problem a circuit is given along with the problem. The circuit diagram is given along with the problem. That circuit diagram is a part of problem. The circuit diagram is of tank circuit. Let us see what they have given. Calculate the frequency. This is a problem number 4. Idu problem number 4 agide itala. Calculate the frequency and feedback ratio. Calculate the frequency and feedback ratio of the circuit shown below. So they are asking us to calculate the frequency and feedback ratio of the circuit shown below. In the diagram, they have given a circuit which is of tank circuit of Colpitts oscillator. Let me write the circuit diagram first. ten micro henry and this is 0.22 micro farad and this one is 0.47 micro farad. See, in this is the circuit diagram they have given. Clearly it is a circuit diagram of, or this circuit represents the tank circuit. They have given simply the values. They have not mentioned whether it is L or C2 or C1. We need to assign the names to these components. Let L is equal to value of inductor given in the circuit diagram is 10 micro henry. That is 10 micro henry. And let it be C1, let this capacitor be C1. Value of C1 is equal to 0.22 microfarad. And let the name of this capacitor be C2. C2 is equal to 0.47 microfarad. Let me find out the inductor values. F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. 1 divided by root LC. Here, before finding the frequency value, we should find out the equivalent capacitance value. Equivalent capacitance value na find out markondo now munde frequency na find out madbekagutte. To find out the equivalent capacitance value, let me write this formula. C is equal to C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Let me substitute the values here. Value of C1 is 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 0.47 into 10 to the power of minus 6 whole divided by 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6 plus 0.47 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So after simplification, the answer is 0.15 microfarad. This is the equivalent value of capacitance. Let me substitute this C value here. Let me substitute the value in this formula 1 divided by 2 pi into root of L. L value. What is the value of L here? 10 microhenry. So 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into capacitance value is 0.15 microfarad. 0.15 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So after simplification, we will get the frequency value. Point 0.13 megahertz. We'll get this answer. So this is about. See, we solved four problems on Colpitts oscillator. Now let us solve some problems on Hartley oscillator. Problem number 5 to problem number 8, all four problems are related to Hartley oscillator concept. Let us solve them. Let me erase this board. Let me clean the board first. Before starting solving the problems, let me write the and one more thing here we need to find out. So in this problem number 4 only, they asked us to calculate the feedback ratio. We need to find out the feedback ratio. Feedback ratio can be find out by using the formula B2 is equal to C1 into C2. We know the value of C1 and C2. We find out, we have the values of C1 and C2 here. So value of C1 is 0.22 into 10 power minus 6. Value of C2 is 0.47 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Here 10 to the power of 6 gets cancelled, and this one, take the ratio of 0.22 divided by 0.47 is equal to 0.46 is the feedback ratio. This is also problem number 4. Problem number 4 aayitu idadmele iga problem number 5 ge hogana. Problem number 5 is related to Hartley oscillator. Let me read the problem first. Problem number 5. A Hartley oscillator has L1 is equal to 3 millihenry. And L2 is equal to 5 millihenry. And C is equal to 10 nanofarad. Determine the frequency of oscillations. Here, while solving Hartley oscillator to find out the frequency, we make use of this expression F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. This is the same formula which was used to find out the frequency generated by the Colpitts oscillator. Same formula is used here. But the thing is, here since it is a Hartley oscillator, the tank circuit consists of only one capacitor, that is C. But there will be two inductors in the tank circuit of Hartley oscillator. Therefore, the inductor value L is equal to L1 plus L2. So, here the tank circuit consists of two inductors which are serially connected. Therefore, their effective inductance value will be L is equal to L1 plus L2. By using this formula, we will determine the value of inductor first. And after finding out the effective inductance value, that value will be substituted in this expression in order to find out the frequency. Here, let us do same thing. Let us find out the effective inductance value, that is L is equal to L1 plus L2. calculations are very much easier when compared to calculation in this Hartley oscillator part is very much easier when compared to Colpitts oscillator part. L is equal to L1 plus L2, that is 3 millihenry plus 5 millihenry. 3 into 10 power minus 3, because it is in the range of milli. 5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. See, therefore L will be 8 into 10 to the power of minus 3, that is 8 millihenry. This is the effective inductance value. Let me substitute the effective inductance value in the frequency expression, that is F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. 1 divided by 2 into 3.14 into root of L value is 8. 8 into 10 power minus 3 into capacitor value is 10 nanofarad. So 10 into 10 to the power of minus 9. So let us see what will be the frequency value. The answer is 17.8 kilohertz. 17.8 kilohertz is the answer. Now let us move on to problem number 6. A Hartley oscillator circuit is to generate a frequency of 1200 kilohertz. If the capacitor in the feedback network has a value of 220 picofarad and one of the inductor value is 20 henry, calculate the value of other inductor. So this is the problem number 6. Problem number 6 in your exercise. Let me read the problem once again and start solving the problem. Once again, I am telling, this is the problem number 6 in the exercise of the chapter oscillator. Let me read the problem once again. A Hartley oscillator circuit is to generate the frequency of 1200 kilohertz. The frequency is given, that is 1200 kilohertz. This Hartley oscillator is used to generate the frequency of 1200 kilohertz. If the capacitor of the feedback network has a value of 220 picofarad, capacitor value is given, that is 220 picofarad, and One of the inductor's value is, inductor's value is 20 micro Henry. Let it be L1. You bekadre L2 anta nadru kotkoli. Nan L1 anta kotkondidini. L1 kotre L2 equate madbekagutte. L2 kotre L1 anta equate madbekagutte. So illi nan L1 kotkondidini. Value of L1, let the L1 be 20 microfarad. We need to find out the value of L2. Look at here. To find out the value of L2, we have a formula. L is equal to L1 plus L2. So, then L2 equate madadre. If we equate this expression to L2, we will get L minus L1. That means, we know the value of L1, but we don't know the value of L. L means it is an equivalent inductance value. To find out the equivalent inductance value, we will make use of this formula. L is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. If we equate this expression to L, then we will get the expression L is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi square F square into C. Itara formula barata. If I substitute all the values to this formula, we'll get the expression of L. Sorry, we'll get the value of L. So, L is equal to 1 divided by 4 into 3.14 square. Pi square anta andre 3.14 square into frequency value is 1200 kilohertz. That is 1200 into 10 to the power of 3 whole square. Into next capacitance value. So capacitance value is 220 pico, that is 220 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So let me calculate the answer. So 1 divided by 80 millihenry is the answer. Now 80 microhenry. Answer is 80 microhenry. It is microhenry. Now, by using this formula, let us find out the L2 value. So, L2 is equal to 80 into 10 to the power of minus 6 minus L1 value is 20. That is 20 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So, we got 60 micro Henry. Namigil bandha answer eshtu anta andre 60 micro Henry answer barate. 60 micro Henry. So, this is the answer. 60 micro Henry. So, itara answer barate. So, this is solution to problem number 6. Now, let us move on to next problem, that is problem number 7. Problem number 7 ikku hogana. Let me read the problem first. A Hartley oscillator oscillates at 54 kilohertz. The inductors used have inductances L1 is equal to 30 millihenry and L2 is equal to 60 millihenry. Find the value of capacitance of the capacitor. So let me clean the board and let us do the problem. Problem number 7. Yenide a Hartley oscillator oscillates at 54 kilohertz, that is frequency kottidara. So 54 kilohertz is the output frequency, and they have given the inductor values. They have given the inductor values of both the inductors. L1 is equal to 30 micro millihenry and L2 is equal to 60 millihenry. So L1 is equal to 30 millihenry, L2 is equal to 60 millihenry. Next, find the value of capacitance of capacitor. So let us find out the first let us first find out the effective inductance value, that is L is equal to L1 plus L2. L1 value is 30 millihenry plus this is 60 millihenry. So effective inductance value is 90 millihenry. So 90 millihenry one badate. So frequency, let us find out the frequency. Frequency they have given. We need to find out the inductance, capacitance value. For that we'll make use of frequency expression, that is F is equal to 2 pi root LC. On equating this expression to L value, we'll get the expression L is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi square F square into C. So in this formula, if we substitute all the values, we'll find out the L. In this formula, if we substitute all the known values, then we'll find out the capacitance value. So ee formula heg bantu andre ee expression anna C equate ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅದೇ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ನೀವು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಮೆಮೊರೈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಈಕ್ವೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮೀಟರ್ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅದು ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅದೇ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? ಸೊ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ÷ 4 ಇಂಟು 3.14 ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ into frequency 54 kilohertz, 54 into 10 to the power of 3, 54 kilo square ide adu, into L value, inductance value 90 millihenry, 90 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So eshtu baruthe, let us calculate the capacitance value. So the answer is 96.52 picofarad, because answer is in the range of 10 to the power of minus 12, therefore I written picofarad. So this is the capacitance value. Now let us move on to next problem, that is problem number 7, problem number 7 aitu, problem number 8. Let us move on to next problem, that is problem number 8. This problem number 8, this also, in this problem also they have given the circuit diagram of tank circuit. Illi tank circuit and circuit diagram kottidare, adanna nodkondo naavu problem na solve maartta hogbekagutte. Let us solve the problem. Problem number 8. Calculate the frequency and feedback ratio. Calculate the frequency and feedback ratio of the circuit shown below. That means they have given a circuit along with the question. That means circuit is a part of question. By looking at the circuit and by verifying the values given in the circuit, we need to find out the frequency and feedback ratio of that circuit. Let me draw the circuit first. That is the circuit diagram of tank circuit of Hartley oscillator. They have given the circuit diagram of tank circuit of Hartley oscillator. Hartley oscillator consists of one capacitor and two inductors in its tank circuit. So this is that tank circuit. Let me write the values here. This is 1000 picofarad. The capacitor value is 1000 picofarad. Capacitor value is 1000 picofarad. Inductor's value 6.8 millihenry, and second inductor value is 1.2 millihenry. So it is still there. Let me assign the names to them. Let it be C. Capacitor ge nano C anta hesaru kottukottini. Let the name of this inductor is L1. Let the name of this inductor is L2. Let me find out the effective inductance value. Effective inductance value L is equal to L1 plus L2. So L is to the 6.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 plus 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Ithara ide. So L is equal to eshtu baruthe allige anta andre nimge 8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 athava 8 millihenry is the inductance value. Now let us find out the frequency of this tank circuit, that is F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. 1 divided by 2 into 3.14 into root of value of L is 8 milli, that is 8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into C. Capacitance value is 1000 picofarad, that is 1000 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Let me calculate the answer. answer is 56,298 hertz, athava we can write it as 56.298 kilohertz. This is the frequency generated by this tank circuit. Now we need to find out the feedback fraction or feedback ratio. That can be find out by using the relation beta is equal to L2 divided by L1. So, ee tara equation na ill balaskoltivi. So, the value of L2 is 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 6.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3. 10 to the power of minus 3, minus 3. The numerator and denominator common, they cancels each other. Now, the answer is 1.2 divided by 6.8. 0.176. So, this is the feedback fraction athava feedback ratio. So, this is the problem. So, illige we have solved all the problems related to Colpitts oscillator and Hartley oscillators from your exercise part. So, nimma exercise part alli iddantaha Hartley oscillator matte Colpitts oscillator related iruvanta ella problem galu enittu adna solve maadidivi. The thing is you need to solve the solid examples given in your textbook alli solid example kottidare along with the solution kottidare adanna mattondalla practice maadi solve maadantadu enilla you need to practice them to get the perfection. So this is about problems these are the problems about Hartley and Colpitts oscillator. In the next session let us discuss about RC oscillators. RC oscillator